Hello and welcome all. Here we are looking at a question. Write a program in C++ program to count the occurrence of a character J. Yeah, J is in capital in a given string. This question was asked in March 2010 in the board exam. Let us discuss this question and at the same time we'll be looking at the solution of this. Okay, so let us start the solution. First, it is given that we are supposed to write this program using string. Okay, they haven't mentioned whether you are supposed to use the class or not, or whether you are supposed to use a user defined function. So it is just a straightforward question. So whenever such type of questions comes in the exam, please focus on the question and things they have asked in the question itself. Don't try to do the same program using class or user defined function, in which there might be a possibility that you may make some mistakes. So let us start with the solution. Since we are supposed to count the number of occurrence of a given character J in a given string, we need a string. As you know that in C++ there is no data type for string, so we will be creating a character array. So character array str, suppose the size of an array is 100, it is more than enough. Then we are supposed to count the character J. We don't have to declare it, we will just directly compare it in the if statement. Besides that, I don't remember which variable we have to take. So we will start writing the program, and if we will be needing any more variables, we will take it. Now for dealing with string, we also need to include two new header files, that is hash include stdio. At the same time, we will also need hash include string. Okay, here you will notice that we haven't written .h because it is an online editor and it does not require to include .h over here. Okay, now cout enter a string. For reading a string, we don't use a cin statement, we use gets. Gets stands for get string. So gets str, we just have to pass a variable, that is str that we have declared over here. Now we will just try to show the string whether we are doing the program correct or not. So the given string is, and like gets, we also have a function called puts, which displays the string. Okay, semicolon. Let us just run this part so that we will understand whether we are doing it fine or not. There is an error. Compilation terminated. I guess we have to include .h over here. Let me try it. Run. Okay, now it is showing that cout. Int main, expected initialization before cout. Okay, I haven't specified semicolon. I have to end the statement using semicolon. Okay. Now it is showing me enter the string. Okay, these are some warnings, you can ignore it. Enter the string. For example, I'll be entering hello world. Okay, now I will press enter. Hello world, given string is, it is perfect, it is working fine. Now I will minimize it and come to our logic. That is, now we have to check each character and see whether that character is J or not. Okay, for that we will need to run a loop. Okay, for I equals to 0, since it is an array, the loop will start from 0, and we have to specify the condition over here in the loop. So to specify the condition, we will need a length of an array, because if you have seen that the size of an array is 100 over here, but I have entered only hello world, and the size of hello world was approximately 11 characters. It was 11 characters. So we have to get the length of the string so that the loop will be executed only till that particular length, not till all the 100 characters. because the loops are automatically terminated with a null character. So to get the length of the string, we will need a variable l equals to and a function called string length. So in string length we will pass the string. Now you can observe that I have created two more variables, that is l to store the length and I for loop. So here I will create two more variables, that is I comma l, which are of integer type. Now I'll be passing l over here, then I plus plus, and inside the loop I'll be checking a condition. If str of I is exactly equals to inside single quotes j, because we are checking a single character, so a character is written inside a single quotes. Now if this condition matches, then I have to count it. So I will need a variable count which will be incremented, it is count plus plus. So I will also need to declare this count variable whose initial value will be 0. Initially the count is 0. Okay, now after this loop I'll be printing this count. So the total number of j in the given string is cout count. Okay, let's see. So I will run this program now. These are the basic errors we get while we execute a program online. Fine, it is working now. So I will just enter the string, and now I'll be entering again hello world. You can observe that the hello world will display the count as 0, because in hello world there is no j. So the count is 0. So the program is working fine. Let me execute the program again and see the number of counts by entering a j. So Jack and Jill went up the hill. Okay, so there are two j's over here, so it is counting number of j's 2. Now if you will observe that in this program we have only specified a capital J. In the question also they have specified a capital J, but suppose that if a string contains a small j, then you just have to add or over here and str of I exactly equals to small j, then this program will work for capital as well as small. So let me run this program again, and now I'll be entering again Jack and Jill, but now I'll be entering capital as well as small went up the hill. Perfect, now it is showing me two characters. So whenever such type of programs come in the board exam, try to focus and write the answer as per the questions they have asked. Don't try to do the program in class or in function if they haven't specified anything in the question. If you have any other questions besides that, you can post the questions in the comment, and I'll be giving the answers to it as soon as possible. Thank you and have a great day.